Don't forget to invite me for the next one. If I don't have classes, I will come to watch it.
You want to look a fashion show?
Yeah, just for fun.
Okay.
在我们第十八周，等一下，我让我给他完整的说一下。
When is the next one?
Let me see.
Today I couldn't come because I was having classes.
没有，就周二。 You can see us.
你直接用网易翻译，然后把你打出来翻译给他看就好了。
What did he say?
老师就是想看秀是不？ I can use the app to you.
Yes, you send me a message. Yeah, yeah. You have my. That's why I ask your permission.
你翻译吧，你直接打。能不能用九键？下第十八周。
June 24. That's gonna be nice.
Yeah.
Okay.
我外卖来了，你们谁接的？第十八周就是。So, sorry.
So this is gonna be June, right? So, month. May, June 24 here?
Yes.
June 24?
Yes.
Okay. All week? One show every day? What do you mean? What does she mean all week?
咱们是第十八周就是结束了还是？那周都是秀。 Yes, all week.
Okay. In this building?
No.
在一楼。 Yes.
Okay. What? Okay. So what time? In the morning? Afternoon?
Afternoon.
Afternoon.
Yes.
Okay. So I will send her a message and ask her what time, and then she tell me I come.
Yes, yes.
Okay, do you want to have my wishing too?
Okay.
Okay. Okay. Do you want to scan? Okay, you scan me, okay.
Thank you.
So, this is you, right?
Yes, my English name is Christina.
Christina?
Yes.
Are you studying English? Are you studying English?
A little.
A little, okay. So, translate. This is your Chinese name?
No.
No? Because here says I'm Xiu Yu.
No, Guo Zhao Yu. Guo Zhao.
Okay, Guo Zhao Yu.
Yes.
Okay. Change the name here.
Teacher, we will notify you when the time comes.
Yeah, okay, please don't forget, okay?
Okay.
Okay, thank you, thank you.
Thank you, teacher, bye-bye.
Okay, bye-bye.
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 All right, nice to meet you guys. See you in the fashion show. Bye-bye.
Hello.
Hello.
blog is terrific. Great pictures.
I have been writing for quite some time now.
他们去找了一个话筒，因为这个孩子们他们之前我没有到现场，你看他们有评委提问的时候都没有话筒。
应该还有提问吗？
有提问环节。
说一下环节。
没事，这个马塞洛他准备的有 questions， 你们有问也可以随也可以随机问。对对，任何问题没问题的。
是有时间，是有计时的。
他这个没有，因为就九个人。我看他们的稿子了，都很短，每个人也就最多三分钟，嗯，
所以就不用计时，
不用计时，嗯。
This picture here, this temple is inside. It's very, very beautiful.
Yeah.
I wrote this blog post here, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then I put the pictures. This is in Salt Lake City.Yeah, this is one of the temples.
This is not, this is the main thing. This is the main thing. This is the main thing. This is the main
thing.
This is the main thing. This is the main thing. This is the main thing. This is the main thing. This is the main thing. This is the main thing. This is the main thing.这个学生他们感觉还是没有啥经验，所以你看都没有准备好这个老师的话筒，包括学生到场的观众，我感觉通知的也不到位。他应该在全校范围内通知，他只发了外语圈的通知。我刚才跟学生会主席我说，你这个活动是校团委过来，这校团应该准备的是校团委和外语学院，是吧？你就不能够只改那个什么。那个比赛都是到基本上到下学期了。
是演讲比赛还是挺锻炼学生的。
咱学院就是除了就是主办那个之外，咱每个学期都会举办，上学期下学期会举办，就是基本上会举办两到三场，就是根据因为咱们这是咱自己回头他们社团，就比如咱学院这个新梦想协会，他们组织的也有演讲比赛，每年的题目都是不固定的。对，今年是因为它是一个竞题演讲，是因为它是一个雷锋活动月的一个活动要求，咱就举办了这样的一个形式。但是感觉不好的都是这个观众感觉有点太少了。
嗯，他通知的有点局限。
对，他不应该只通知外语学院，应该通知全，因为咱学院才多少人呢，好多学生还有共享课，应该都是全校广而告之，西区的学生都可以通知过来看呀。
对，
南区的，你这样的话才能形成好的气氛呢。
对，多多的报名参加。
嗯，他初赛已经举行过了，现在就这是现在是决赛环节。
大型的。
Use the Google Calendar?
No.
But
Download the app.
Yes, the app is working this, the Chinese phone. This app. The other apps like a Facebook, Google doesn't work in Chinese phone. I don't know, maybe they let just this one. Because this is my Chinese one, so I tried to put other stuff here, it doesn't work, it doesn't let me install the other. For example, these are Western apps, right? Kindle from Amazon also works. Skype also works. I think these are the only three apps that I put here that are not from the not from China. Skype, Google Translate, and Kindle. The other ones are all Chinese. But this one was working in China until 1.5 years ago. Now it's not working in the band. LinkedIn.
Yeah. I can log into the Facebook.
But you're using VPN, right? Eh? So I do have the other phone, right? The Brazilian phone. There I can have. There I have Facebook, a bank in Brazil, and everything else that I needed. But I never use it. I leave the phone back at home, right? So I only carry this one.
单词才能推，因为他们要考试。
哦，
亲爱的同学们，
大家晚上好，
欢迎大家来到由河南工程学院外语学院举办的主题为大学生如何践行雷锋精神的英文演讲大赛决赛现场。我是主持人刘浩然。
我是主持人王春吴。春回大地，万物复苏，在这春意盎然的季节里，我们迎来了向雷锋同志学习的第61个年头。
近半个世纪以来，雷锋精神感染了一代又一代的人们，他们已经深深地融入在了人们心灵深处。
历经61载，神州大地上高扬的雷锋精神始终熠熠生辉。雷锋精神已经成为我们民族精神中不可或缺的一部分。
同学们曾几何时唱着嘹亮雄壮的雷锋歌，怀着单纯的梦想，用一颗善良的心和一双勤劳的手博取别人的称赞。
那时的天空清新明朗，人们笑容灿烂，雷锋是大家心中的神话，一声雷锋叔叔蕴含着无限的敬仰与崇敬之情。
在离开雷锋的日子里， 人们用心延续着雷锋的生命，延续着刻苦钻研的精神，延续着勤俭节约的自强精神，成百上千的活雷锋应时而生。
在当今雷锋精神不断地被丰富升华，不断地被赋予新的内容，我们的身边许许多多的活雷锋通过他们无私的言行与奉献，诠释了新时代雷锋精神，极大地丰富了雷锋精神的内涵。
为了缅怀心中英雄，为了弘扬雷锋精神，我们今天用自己的方式共同纪念这个不朽的灵魂。
下面由我来介绍参加今天活动的校领导和评委老师，外籍教师莫塞罗。
正式开始前，由我来宣读评分细则。此次比赛共四位评委老师，选手的最终得分取四位评委所打的平均分，最终成绩从高到低排序，决出一等奖一名，二等奖两名，三等奖三名。
下面我宣布，以如何践行雷锋精神为主题的英文演讲比赛正式开始。
第一位有请王俊浩同学带来演讲，请王露露同学做好准备。
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. It's an honor to be able to be here. You know, I feel a little nervous because I never see so many English teachers and students listen to my English speech. Okay, the topic of my speech is 10 years to learn for Lei Feng Berry. You know, at that time, Lei Feng, the name, is not only a historical symbol, but also a spiritual symbol. So our teenagers should learn for Lei Feng Berry. But how should we learn for Lei Feng Berry? And now I will use my experience to answer the question. 2 months ago, I take part in an activity named the Survival Blind. You know the mean Survival Blind is a group for students. Survive 2 days in Xinjiang. It sounds not very difficult, but you just have 5 yuan. One person 5 yuan, 2 days. Okay, sounds a little difficult, but it's not impossible. What's most interesting, you can just speak English. Oh my god. The first time I hear that news, I think it's impossible for me. Maybe it's not a survival plan, it will be a better plan. But our teacher encouraged us, just do it. So we tried ourselves. At first, we make a poster that showed our survival plan, tell the people our plan, and we are students from Sanan Gongcheng. First day, we went to Hershey Square. We just walk and walk. We don't know how to do. Suddenly, the gorgeous lady see our poster and be interested about our poster. She asked our active. Our leader explained our survival plan. She said, wow, all of you guys is so brave. And I'll be very interesting about your active. And show your QR code. What? Show your QR code. Okay. Our leader showed her WeChat QR code. And she gave us 88 yuan at that time. Oh my god. 88 yuan. 4 person. We can survive 2 days. It's not very difficult, right? I think he's a really, really good person. And it really do the living spirit. At that time, I think I will do a person as the lady. And another experience is in our school. One time, I take my food with my dormitory. I see there are 2 students have some problems. I think maybe they don't need my help. I just want to go my dormitory. But I remember that Lei Feng said, if you are a little water, would you water the line? If you are a little fire, would you shine the darkness? If you are a little food, would you feed the life? And ask them whether I can help them. Then we just don't know where is our school restaurant. I tell them. At that time, I feel very happy. if I can just use one word to describe my mood, I think this word it will be satisfied. Always aim high, work hard, and care deeply about what you believe in. And when you stumble, keep faith. And when you knock down, get right back up. And never listen to anyone who says you can or shouldn't go on. So as our teenagers, we should find those who need help instead of wait. Lei Feng says, life is limited, but there's no limit to serving for people. So our teenagers should learn from Lei Feng's spirit so that Lei Feng's spirit can pass on. That's all. Thanks for listening.
Just a minute.
Okay, why did you choose to talk this subject? Why did you choose this subject?
Because I think our students, for our generation, we should learn from Lei Feng's spirit. It's useful for our life. If you can help others, just do it. You will feel very happy and confident. What's more, if somebody can help us, we will feel very happy too.
All right, thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah. The next one, Sai.
I was forgetting about that.
感谢王春浩同学带来的精彩演讲。下面有请王璐璐同学进行演讲，郑基金同学做好准备。
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. The topic today I will talk about is inherit the spirit of Lei Feng and be a qualified college student. Suppose that you see a screw spike. What would come to your mind and actively associate with this item? From the perspective of practical utilitarianism, maybe you think that is kind of item to repair or fix something like that. But actually, it symbolizes a kind of spirit of socialism and patriotism, who aligning his personal career with the development of the nation and country. Once upon a time, Lei Feng come back from Dandong and go to Shenyang. He carrying a big backpack, and through the underground passage, he see a white-haired old woman and asked, "Where are you going?" The aunt replied, "I'm going to Shun to see my son." When the Lei Feng seen the old women with the white hair leaning on a stick, walking difficultly step by step, and carrying a big parcel, he immediately take over the parcel and support the old lady with his hand. From this way, we can say Lei Feng's spirit influenced everybody. And he also put his theory, put the value of his life into the practice. Love the mainland and love the socialism, dedicated to put himself into the society. And love in one line and special in one line are all the true portrayals of him. Lei Feng's spirit also the most precious human mental health around all of the world with the power of transcending the limits of time and place. One key important, how should we carry forward this kind of morality? It's worth to thinking for our college students. Several years we just calling for something, now to really do something. Actions be louder than words. For our college students or contemporary youth, here are some concrete steps can be taken. First and foremost, we can to conduct the spirit interview, Lei Feng spirit around us, to select someone as a moral models so as to influence more people to do the good deeds like Lei Feng. Secondly, we can also do some very little thing around us, like to turn off the tap that is dripping water. And we can also clean the blackboard ahead of time before the teacher came into the classroom. We can also do some housework for our parents who have been working all the day. So anything is touchable. We should put it into the practice. Certainly. And we can also do some voluntary practice, such as the blood donation and the fundraising, like that. Last but not least, how should our college students really to get to make our country to realize a national rejuvenation? We should improve our professional knowledge, actually, by taking full advantage of our major. We can to contribute our wisdom strengths to the realization of the secondary scenario goal, to realize the China's dream. So, no time is place. Just someone take the burden, take the responsibility for us. We should do something, not just the calling. Only in this way can we enjoy a better life and get a win-win cooperation. And only in this way can we build a community with a shared future and gain the international voice in a competitive world. Thank you.
How did you prepare or research for your speech?
Firstly, I will search some information about Leifeng and according my own analysis to generate, to get generation. And I also take some writing skills or the competition or examination to practice my writing skills or speech learning skills. Most importantly, I will to practice my tone or my performance towards the mirror to watch my action, my contact, or some other reflection like that.
Okay, thank you.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Zheng Qixin, come from English 2342. Today, I'm honored to speak with you about how contemporary can embody the spirit of Leifeng. Leifeng was a Chinese soldier renowned for his selflessness, dedication to helping others, and commitment to socialism. But in our fast-paced and often self-centered world, the spirit of Leifeng is relevant than ever before. But how can we live out the essence in our daily lives? Firstly, let's understand the essence of Leifeng's spirit is not just in grand gesture, but in small acts of kindness and helpfulness we show to others every day. It's about recognizing the needs of mandate and representing to with campaigns and action. We can volunteering in our communities, whether it be cleaning up the public areas, helping at local charities, or tutoring less privileged children. These are small actions, but these small actions not only contribute positively to society, but also enrich our own life by fostering the sense of purpose and fulfillment. Education is another area that today's youth can embrace the spirit of Lei Feng by sharing the knowledge and resources, assisting pairs to with their studies, taking part in environmental educational initiatives. We can, moreover, practicing the spirit of Lei Feng, it means that cultivating the mandate of gratitude and service. Gratitude and service, it involves the being a mindful for our action or impact on others, always striving to make a positively indifference in someone's day. In conclusion, the spirit of Lei Feng is timeless. It's timeless, and it beckons us to reflect on how can we create a positively spirit of Lei Feng. Let's remember that even the smallest gesture of kindness can have a profound impact. By living the spirit of Lei Feng, we can make a ripple effect of positivity and compassion, shaping a better world for future generations. That's all. Thank you.
Okay, what do you hope that the audience will get from your speech?
I hope they can do more small acts to help others and give those in need in their daily lives and have a positive attitude to life.
Okay, thank you.
Recycling old clothes, writing the law and repairing the computers. Next, we should establish a correct employment outlook and values and strive to improve our abilities. We should learn from the spirit. We should learn from the example of Lei Feng and acquiring multiple skills regardless of social status As college students, we should be dedicated and loyal to our work. We should act constantly striving our fields, be proactive, strive to realize our social values. Finally, young people should strengthen social practice. We should learn from the excellent qualities of Leifeng spirit, be willing to help others, start with small things, accumulate good deeds, and never considering a good deed too small to be done. As college students, we should actively participating various volunteer services, such as visiting orphanage and old people's homes, offering voluntary services, spontaneously donating blood. I'm appeal to everyone to carry forward the spirit of Leifeng. This is why I'm here to discuss you the spirit of Leifeng with you. Thank you. That's all for my speech.
Hello. Thank you very much, Xiaoyi. You're so confident, positive, energetic. From your public speech here, you see highly of Leifeng spirit. I'm so glad to hear. There are so many activities or stories that happened in your speech. It's good. I enjoy it much. So Leifeng spirit is a kind of a spirit of the time and of our nation. So everybody should learn from it, right?
Yeah.
So Leifeng is everywhere. It's in the street. It's also on our campus, right? Okay. So we'd better use our eyes to discover, right? Use our ear to enjoy. Use our heart to experience, right? So could you give me a one or two examples to show how of the Leifeng in our campus, in our university? So that is Hegong Leifeng. Give us a one or two stories, because I want to know more information.
Okay.
Oh, thank you very much.
Thank you for your question. In my after class, on my way to dormitory, I went to some people's package down the road. I will pick it and give them. And if I find the baggage in the garden, I always pick it. But I think this situation is limit for me. In my daily life, I always shy.
I just ask you to tell me some stories about Hegong Leifeng. Maybe, boy or girl, not yourself, right?
Okay.
Hegong Leifeng, maybe he or maybe she. Yeah. Some more examples or stories about Hegong. Just now, use your eyes to discover, right?
Okay.
Use your ear to listen, and use your heart to experience. So, could you use your 智慧的双眼 to find some stories and some examples about Hegong Leifeng? Because this is really a good way to share the story, to promote this kind of Leifeng spirit, right?
During the epidemic in our campus, there are many volunteers to protect the campus. In the in the door, just in the door, during the National Day. We will find many volunteers in the dormitory. They all do the little things or big things to protect our health. Thank you.
Okay, good. So good. Oh, thank you very much. Thank you for your cooperation.
谢高小怡同学的精彩演讲，下面有请陈夏宁同学为我们带来演讲，请张子玉同学做好准备。
Ladies and gentlemen, dear friends, good evening. My name is Chen Xiangying, an English major from English 2242.It's my great honor to stand here today to share with you my thoughts on practicing and inheriting the spirit of Lei Feng for contemporary youth. Lei Feng, a shining example of socialism, is a beloved hero in our country. His spirit represents the core values of socialism, including dedication, selflessness, and altruism.As young people in the 21st century, it's our responsibility to carry forward this precious legacy. So first of all, if we want to learn the spirit of Lei Feng, we must understand Lei Feng's deeds and spirit, draw strength from it, and establish a correct outlook on life, values, and the world. By keeping Lei Feng's spirit in our school, we pay respect to a great hero while we creating a better tomorrow for ourselves and others. So we should let the spirit of Lei Feng continue to inspire us all as we move towards a better future. And another effective way to practice the spirit is to actively participate in volunteer service activities, including we can participate in some tree plants. As we all know, volunteering offers several benefits, including personal growth, community involvement, and learning opportunities. These benefits not only our lives, but also contribute to a stronger and a more competitive society. And finally, in face of adversities and obstacles, we should be bold enough to hold responsibility, advance courageously, and hold accountable for our society and family.By taking responsibility, we force ourselves to improve and grow as we are held accountable for our actions. Through the above measures, we can integrate the spirit of Lei Feng into our daily lives and study. So we can be a young man in the new era with the spirit of Lei Feng.That's all
the
message. Thank you for attention.
Okay, Xiangming, your spoken English is really good. I listen and enjoy your public speech. So you should be confident. You are so confident.
So next time when you give a public speech here, so maybe you will use your body language to show your power, to be more passionate, and then you will feel much better and more confident, right? Because you have very good English pronunciation. So I'm very glad to hear, right? Okay. Just now you talk about the practice about latent spirits. So I said before, latent spirits and also Hegong latent everywhere, right? Including you, right? You're part of Hegong Ren, right? So out of this speech context this evening, how can you practice latent spirits? Maybe think it over and try to tell me one or two things maybe you want to practice latent spirits.
Thank you for the question.
Okay.
For me, as I mentioned before, I would like to participate in volunteer service activities. Several days ago, our school held an activity, and it appeals our students to visit those old people in old people's house. And I think we should actively participate in those activities like that.
I mean, this evening, when we finish this kind of English speech context, on the way to the dormitory, maybe you can do one or more things to practice latent spirits because you are Hegong latent. So maybe you can think it over, give me a story or one example about yourself to practice latent spirits.
This evening?
Yeah, sure, now, right? I'm waiting. I'm very glad to, looking forward for your latent spirits practice.
Maybe after everyone left, I can clean this classroom and pick up those rubbish. And on my way to dormitory, I think because today is windy. I saw many bicycle fell down on the tree. Maybe when I go back to dormitory, I would like to
pick it up and put it on the original place,
yeah.
Right? Okay, good. Thank you very much. Congratulations. Thank you. Okay, good.
The first five?
Yes, first five, yeah.
Okay.
8.35分，王露露同学9.0分，郑其新同学7.6分，高小怡同学8.214分，陈香宁同学8.7分，让我们掌声鼓励。下面请秦明月同学，下面请秦明月同学，上台演讲，请王月阳同学做好准备。下面请陈香宁同学上台演讲，请张子玉同学上台演讲，请秦月同学做好准备。
Ladies and gentlemen.
gentlemen. It's my pleasure to have the opportunity to address such a distinguished audience. Today, I'm going to discuss a timeless and revered concept, the Lei Feng spirit. Lei Feng, a selfless and compassionate soldier in China, exemplified the values of altruism, kindness, and dedication to helping others. His legacy continues to inspire generations, urging us to reflect on how we can embody his spirit in our daily lives. We live in a world filled with uncertainties and challenges. It is crucial for us, youth of today, to practice the Lei Feng spirit. Where acts of kindness and compassion are often overshadowed by self-interest and individualism. However, it's through small gestures of kindness we can truly make a difference. So, as a contemporary youth, how we can practice Lei Feng spirit in their lives? First and foremost, let us cultivate empathy and compassion towards those around us. Whether it's leading a listening ear to a friend's need or volunteering at a local charity, every act of kindness, no matter how small, has the power to brighten someone's day. Secondly, let us strive to be role models for positive change in our communities. As actively participating in initiatives that promote social welfare, environmental sustainability, or educational equality, we can contribute to building a more harmonious and inclusive society. Furthermore, let us never underestimate the impact of our actions. No matter how insignificant they may seem, as Lei Feng once said, a drop of water can pierce a rock, not by its strength, but by its persistence. Every act of kindness, no matter how insignificant, has the potential to create a ripple effect of goodwill and inspire others to follow suit. In conclusion, as we navigate the complexities of the modern world, let us remember the timeless wisdom of Lei Feng and strive to be beacons of hope. That's all. Thank you.
Now, I'd like to know, during the Lei Feng activities you mentioned or participated, which activity impressed you the most? And why?
Impressed me most. Yeah. Yesterday, I find two volunteers just at the parking area next to my dormitory, who wear blue vests. They just hang out to arrange the vehicles around, and I just took my computer to the classroom to study, and they saw me. Maybe it's very inconvenient. And two girls just came around me and helped me to push my cars out. Mm-hmm. And that's really they're very helpful to me too. I'm so grateful to them.
Okay, so.
Contemporary people can practice the spirit of Lei Feng. Lei Feng is a communist fighter. His life is extremely rough, but his spirit is immortal. His spirit is a dedication for the party and the people,
self-listeners and self-listeners. However, when I was a kid, I first heard Lei Feng from my aunt, Maggie Dorian. Maggie Dorian was 18 when she took a gap year between high school and college. She packed up a few of her belongings and set out to see the world. Dorian's story began when she walked with poverty-stricken children at a school in northern India. One day she saw a little girl carrying loaves to and from village, but she just earned $2 one day to support her family. Shocked by what she saw, she later found out that there were 80 million children across the globe who lived like hammered. Then she thought to herself, for the first time, forget the 80 million. What if you just started with hammer? That's when Dorian decided to take hammer and her wing and the people for education. But helping hammer wasn't enough for Dorian, because she knew that there were still children without families or homes. So my aunt bought a piece of land for $5,000 with her babysitting savings. Her goal was to build a shelter for those children. The amazing thing about this work is that it's addicting. Since I can help one kid, why not 10? Dorian said. Then I asked my aunt, why are you doing this? My aunt didn't say much to me. She just told me the story of Lei Feng. Then I suddenly realized that the spirit of Lei Feng lies in passing it down from generation to generation. In conclusion, let us all remember that the spirit of Lei Feng is not a relic of past. It's become hope and inspiration for our generation. Let's embrace it, cherish it, and pass it on for our future generation. That's all. Thanks.
Hello, Mingyue. Thanks very much for your vivid story just now you mentioned in your English speech, right? I enjoy it very much. So I guess maybe you are a girl with confidence, thinking. Supposing you are a designer, you are a good designer, you're better to design a plan to practice Lei Feng spirit in our university. So could you maybe propose maybe 3 or 4 activities to promote to practice Lei Feng spirit for all university students in our
Well, thank you for your question.
Maybe it's a little bit challenging or a little bit demanding for you, but I'm waiting for you because you are a girl full of thoughts. I believe so, right? Please.
Yes, I think we can hold the activity to learn Lei Feng spirit, just like keep our campus environment, keep the tree to grow. And we can hold a party to invite many people, include our teacher, our friends, our teenagers, and so on, to share our opinions about Lei Feng, so that we can make the spirit of Lei Feng pass it on and spread out to many people. That's all.
Cool. Okay.
感谢秦明月同学的精彩演讲，下面有请王月阳同学为我们带来演讲，请苏畅同学做好准备。下面有请最后一位同学苏畅同学为我们带来演讲。
Hello everyone, my name is Su Chang and I'm so honored to speak here.
As the saying goes, Lei Feng is a good example. So, Lei Feng has many good qualities to learn from. But we have to think, how should we learn the spirit of Lei Feng in the new age? In my opinion, different strategies should be applied in different departments. For example, schools should strengthen this aspect of education and set an example to influence students. The internet should increase publicity and so on. But what about our students? First of all, we should be ready to help others. It's an important point of Lei Feng spirit, such as helping the elderly across the road, having classmates offer your seat to the people in need, and so on. Number two, I want to say we should learn Lei Feng's sense of contribution. Do not waste food, water, or other sources. Number three, we should learn Lei Feng's solidarity and love. It's easy just to get along with others harmoniously. As for me, I'm willing to put Lei Feng spirit into practice in my life. As I'm a monitor, my students may ask me for help. They may ask, how to make this feel? How do I get it? Get the teacher's office? How this, how that? So crazy. But for sure, I will do whatever I can to help them. And at the same time, I get pleasure and friendship from it. But what I want to say is that learning language should not be said verbally, but practiced in life. So everyone, go into action right now. Thank you.
Me? Okay, how do you think your speech went? And if you're gonna do it next time, would you do it differently?
And the next time when I speak, I think I should more calm down, and I'm more confident to show what I want to say and to call more people to do what I'm showing. So that's all.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
位同学的精彩表演，最终结果已经揭晓，下面由我来宣读名单。获得三等奖的是王建浩同学，8.35分。张子玉同学8.675分，陈湘宁同学8.70分，获得二等奖的同学是苏畅同学8.9分，王露露同学9.0分，获得一等奖的同学是秦明月同学9.225分。
恭喜这位同学。下面请这位同学上台领奖。请董春梅老师、曲春明老师为三等奖获得者同学颁奖。请夏增强老师为二等奖获得者颁奖。请外籍教师马塞洛老师为一等奖获得学生获奖者颁奖。
我知道。上一次颁红星，其实是先颁三等奖，再颁二等奖，再颁三等奖，对吧？
请三等奖的获奖选手请到台上来。
把那个 PPT 打开吧，把那个 PPT 打开，到下面站着台那边。到这个下面，站在这个。到再往这边加，再往这边加，再往下面。
喜这些同学。到这里，我们的比赛已经接近尾声，相信选手们的精彩表现一定会给诸位留下很深的印象。
让我们以实际行动弘扬雷锋精神，让雷锋精神在我们身上得到延续，让雷锋精神永远焕发新的光彩。
我们坚信雷锋精神这朵中华民族亮丽的道德花蕊，必将在我们的精心呵护下结出精神文明的累累硕果。
一路梨花处处开，雷锋精神代代传。
本次活动到此结束，谢谢大家。
请大家有序，我们请所有的参赛选手到前面合影一面啊。主持人也留下。大家拿着你的证书都可以了，拿着你的证书 OK。 唐老师，请所有的比赛选手到前面来。你站在最前面，站在最前面。现在站一排，站一排。然后咱们的主持人过来，就是站在他们两边，再往这边来，再往这边。然后咱们老师也站在台上来吧。OK， 所有老师都站在台上。同学们可以退场了哈。刚才我来的时候，王先生还说你要不要骗我。
Hello, can I have your WeChat?
Oh, okay.
I want to have the WeChat of the speakers.
Gameiro.
Yes, Gameiro.
Why?
No, Marcelo is the first name. Gameiro is the teacher's family name.
Okay.
My students call me Teacher Gameiro.
Okay, I send it.
Okay. Can I have your WeChat?
Yeah.
Okay. I like to have the chat of the speakers.
Thank you.
Let's
Sir, I have a question now.
Yes.
Where is your teaching class?
Where is my teaching? I teach my, most of my classes are in building 7.
You say, oh, okay.
And
okay.
I teach there on Tuesday, Wednesday.
Oh, okay, okay.
For example, today I was the whole day teaching.
Really?
In building 7, yes. I have 4 classes today. 8 a.m., 10 a.m., 2 p.m., and 4 p.m.
You know, I major in computer. I study for English for 2 months.
Okay.
And my partner and I want to find a foreigner in our school, but we failed.
To practice English?
Yeah.
Okay, okay. So you have my WeChat, right?
Yeah.
Okay, we can eat together sometimes and practice.
Thank you very much.
Okay. You're welcome.
See ya.
Bye-bye. Can I have your WeChat too?
Yeah.
Can I have it? Oh.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
不是在演讲，而是在背稿子，然后还有就是在课堂上回答问题那种感觉，那肯定是不行。你看到那小女孩说的非常好的，就是她是如何二等奖那个女生，她是如何，其实她的发音没有那么好的，但她为什么让她讲了呢？因为她这个演讲，她不仅仅是你的发音的问题，还有一个表现力。她说她要对照着不认同，她上上有同学吧，说你是如何准备的？她说我对照着镜子，然后跟我自己就是那网录了，好像是。晚上去演练，甚至在你们班上说，今天就跟老师进步老师说，我要参加人家的比赛，我想在大家面前表演，是这样的一个情况，知道吧？好吧，
好，
行吧，
谢谢，
没事，
老师再见。
Let's go，
你看，
郑那叫郑什么？郑欣欣。
Okay.
That's me.
Okay.
其实你说你今天晚上其实表现也很不错，但就是我感觉就是怎么说呢，就是还是有点太紧张了。我感觉准备的，总体来说感觉不是准备的特别的那种，就是怎么说，就是其实实际上你看我，就是你比第一个那种非专业的学生，我感觉要。表现得好一些，但是为什么老师给你打分的时候给你打那么多分呢？就是我感觉还是说演讲嘛，我刚才跟陈先生他不是简单的说，要有一种不是简单的背稿子，也不是简单的背台词儿，而是要有什么呀，就是一个 performance 在里面，对吧？虽然这次是优秀，他当时参与了优秀奖是吧？对，而且这个优秀奖可能是一个院级的证书，只要参加重大参与，后边你是不是大一嘛是吧？那你后边的参加之后
So,
would you please give some tips for his speech? I mean, how to practice oral English?
Okay, one thing that I noticed that most students didn't do it, they kind of, they don't use gestures. For example, when you put like a, use your hand gestures, you put more expression in the speech. So it's always better when you use hand gestures. For any like this, just speaking with your mouth like a, is not very good. But when you say, oh, 3 tips, one, the first one, the second one, the third one, right? So you use the attention of the audience. It's always better for you. So for example, don't be afraid to look in their eye, make eye contact. This is good also, right? So these are basic tips. And I can have your WeChat. I can send you something. I wrote something in my blog. So for example, I'm gonna do the same here. I recorded everything. I can maybe put a post and then give it. Oh, this student is kind of, she should be using more hand gesture. This one could improve pronunciation.
Yeah.
I kind of do this kind of analysis so you can look it and watch it and then learn. So I have done this before, so I can maybe share them later.
Okay.
With you, okay? No problem.
He is an English major student.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.还有你看今天晚上问题很多啊，一是观众，宣传力度不够，其次的话就是音响设备，你看所有的同学都没有用上麦克风，你看效果不好，因为之前的时候像象征和参与航都是跟他一届大三，当时搞活动的时候都是要拿话筒过来的，这是第一。第三是什么呢？咱搞学生活动不是你和朱家镇你们三个在搞活动，把学生会的其他部门的同学都要叫过来。 对吧？你不管你是宣传部的，你是企文提部的还是什么的，这是一个学生会的活动，为啥大家不过来呀？在干嘛呢？对吧？你作为学生会的活动，你学生会的成员都不来参加这个活动，你叫你其他同学怎么来参加这个活动呢？对不对？还有就是你们这个，就是这个演讲这个流程，我都不知道，我以为你都准备好了呢。再者说了，你们如果说这个活动不知道怎么举办，就应该邀，甚至是邀请。 外语广播电台或者新梦想上次的协会来助力咱们，咱们社长就是供咱们使用的。把外语广播电台和新梦想的实力要，这两个协会要用起来，对不对？他们都知道怎么像新梦想协会，如果今天这个活动如果新梦想协会搞的，效果肯定就不是这样子的。要不信你看我都不用做任何的 guidance， 没有任何的指导，就像上一次我们大礼堂搞那一次演讲比赛。 还有一个英语歌曲大赛，我没有做任何的指导，全程的，全是他们自己组织的，因为他们知道怎么去做，什么时候设备怎么去调试，然后这个演，那都四五百人呢，大礼堂那边，你想是不是？所以说你们宣传肯定是不到位的，还有你这个台词。So
yeah, you can read it later, but maybe you can watch it later the.
这个演讲这个主持人的。
You can watch in YouTube.
也是不对的，因为你这是英语，我们中文。 对吧？你应该把它写成英文，然后如果需要老师指导的话，让大概老师能看一下，然后我就解释是什么情况，然后你再念，对吧？而且是，而且还是，办公室又不是没有纸，为什么要拍照呢？应该是前三个选手弄完之后收走，然后在第四个人收走，第五个人收走，应该是这样的，不可能到最后一块结束这样再一收，对不对？你站场时间多时间，这就是因为我们今天。 选手怎么说，确实比较短。如果一个选手比较多的话，你肯定经验比较丰富。另外还有就是，这个，整个这个环节，我觉得还是，你像最后颁奖的时候，咔把让评委老师都上去的一个所有同学颁奖，那都不是这样的流程啊！你们都不是第一次搞活动，都是先从优秀奖或者开始，这个叫正七薪是吧？是正七薪吧？
是
正七薪优秀奖，优秀奖他即使没有奖品，应该他们颁个证书，是不是？然后。 然后再就是三等奖，这些都是要有的，是吧？你既然给人家颁，其实他即便是不是，他是优秀奖，对不对？他是优秀奖吧？反正优秀奖，那为啥不让他上台去颁证书？这是咱自己学院的学生，他不介意。那如果人其他学院的学生，你都有发表选，为啥不让上台颁奖？对不对？啊？颁
过了。
颁过了是吧？但是他最后也要上台跟大家合影留念，或者至少也得一个形式上的一个东西。 是吧？你优秀奖，他当时是优秀奖吗？
就是进决赛的全都是优秀奖。
进决赛的全是优秀奖。
然后已经发了。
颁过了，有证书吗？
有，就是还没发，但是有那个。
那你就是出现问题了。他到底拿的是？你像他这个情况，你比如说，以这个。